This is gonna be a very, very random video and my thoughts, and I'm gonna post it because I just felt like sharing. So yeah, stay tuned. It is not about any product recommendation. It is my general view on products and reviews which I'm seeing on the internet. So yeah, please leave your comments down below. The first and foremost point which I want to talk about is we can't simply review a product based on ingredient list. As a YouTuber, I think it is my responsibility to try out that product on my skin and then express my reviews. If I am a chemical formulator or a doctor who prescribes those medicines or those products in a longer run, I think it is still fine. But otherwise speaking, if I am a YouTuber, it is my utmost responsibility to go through the ingredient list and use it on my skin and then share my experience to you, because I am neither a chemical formulator nor a doctor. So just by looking at the ingredient list, I can't review any product whatsoever. The product is made up of some formulas, some chemical reactions, and there might be so many things happening inside, okay? That's why people do recommend to not mix up their products. If that is the case, all the products can be mixed together, all the good products can be mixed together, and you can get a magic cream which will help you get rid of all your dark spots, fine lines, wrinkles and whatsoever. And also there are some people who recommend sunscreens, like if you are using a white cast sunscreen, they ask you to mix it with compact powder and apply it onto your face, but that is not the right way. So we can't simply judge a product based on their ingredient list. That is completely wrong. As a YouTuber, you have to review the product after only using the product on yourself for a minimum duration of around 10 to 15 days. Secondly, you might not see a lot of products on my channel which has perfume, because I really feel that perfume generally sensitizes my skin. It might not sensitize many of you, but yeah, for me, I have a sensitive skin. I have suffered a lot because of perfume, and that's why any product whatsoever will be coming up in my channel will not have perfume. And the last and final thing is, any new brand which is coming up in the market, I am not a very big fan of reviewing all the brands, because I really doubt, because suppose if we take a brand such as Cetaphil or Aveeno, in that case, it has been there in the market for such a long time. It has been tested by millions of people. People do recommend it, and that's why in this year I've fallen in love with Cetaphil as a brand. And there will be videos soon on Cetaphil products on my channel. But anyways, Cetaphil might be catering to a particular set of people, like for oily skin people or dry skin people. But I want to mention that when a brand is coming up, when it is a new brand, it is really difficult to review those products, because it is new in the market and it has not been tested on a varied range of people. So don't completely trust new brand altogether, okay? So I don't want to mention about any such brand in this video, but there are some new brands which have come up with their products and which didn't work out and which was promoted.